Duffy and Linda Gray will always be remembered for their roles in the primetime TV soap Dallas. And while the duo enjoyed starring in the phenomenally successful show, both Patrick and Linda endured incredible heartache, as Angela Bishop discovered when she caught up with them for this TV exclusive.
It was the soap opera that revolutionised primetime drama. Dallas started out as a five-part miniseries in 1978, but ended up running for 13 years.
What made Dallas so popular? If you knew, there'd be 50 Dallases.
Dallas focused on the tumultuous exploits of the Ewing family.
I meant what I said, darling. I'm glad you're back.
We had an environment in the workplace of happily married people. You know, Larry and his wife were married how long?
53 years.
In 2012, Dallas was revived with Larry Hagman, Patrick and Linda reprising their roles.
But the best decision you ever made was the day you walked away from me.
Larry and Linda and I have been the closest friends for 35 years, so there was a bit of an oasis where we weren't able to work together. You know, when the show was canceled in 91, we didn't work together after that because nobody would hire the three of us to appear because everybody would think it's Bobby, JR and Sue Ellen. So, or I mean, sorry, Sue Ellen, JR and Bobby. She's such a prima donna.
Yes, JR. The answer is yes. You were the love of my life.
But the new Dallas couldn't withstand the loss of the much-loved villain, JR Ewing. And Larry Hagman's death from cancer signalled the end of the show.
But he got to leave the planet playing the role he was put on the planet to play, in my estimation.
Right.
And he went out as J.R. Ewing.
So and he said that every time almost he was on the set. He said, can you believe it? 80 years old, and here I am on a television show again. He was so appreciative every minute. So it was the best thing ever. We just lost him too soon.
Linda is one of the showbiz world's most recognisable faces. But she recently revealed it's another body part that was once in high demand.
Linda, your legs look so fantastic today, and I've now grabbed this copy of your book, and they look fantastic on the cover, and they look fantastic on the back. Your legs are incredible. You look amazing.
I'll just go wait in the car.
Okay, now you can just stay over there. It's fine.
Can't I reveal a little bit that,
yeah, of course,
that the legs in The Graduate belong to you, not Anne Bancroft?
That's true.
They are these legs.
They are these legs. See?
Now he's right out.
There we go.
How did that come about?
So he couldn't stay away. No. I was testing him.
Yeah.
A photographer, a dear friend of mine, I was a model at that time, and he called me. He said, I need your legs. I said, okay. How much? He said, $25. I said, sure. I mean, what was I thinking?
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me.
Linda's personal life has gone through as many ups and downs as her on-screen persona, Sue Ellen.
Then when Dallas came and I had to go to Dallas, Texas, that was the first time I'd been away. And my husband didn't like me to be doing that.
To be successful?
Yeah, very successful. And it was very challenging for him.
Yeah.
And then I had the guilt, the mother guilt of like, look what I'm doing and maybe it's all my fault. And there was a bit of me that said, follow your dream. And it wasn't follow your dream and leave your family behind. It was let's all huddle together. How can we make this work? And so it did for a while I was doing Dallas. But then it didn't because it wasn't the support system that Patrick and Larry had.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and
so I had to move on.
And speaking for the frailty of men's egos, I think it's so much harder for a woman to establish that type of determination and do it successfully than it is for a man. And and I was fortunate. My wife had a career and her career was over, and so she was very happy as a housewife, homekeeper and mother. And when we went to Dallas, the whole family would go. So it was a completely different situation for Linda, and it was much more difficult.
Patrick's wife of 43 years introduced the actor to Buddhism, and he credits the religion with helping him through a very dark time.
Patrick, you had a terrible tragedy in your family.
Oh, and my parents were murdered, right?
Terence and Marie Duffy were killed during an armed robbery at the Montana bar they owned. The gunmen were just 19.
It was round the world newsworthy at the time because of the prominence of the show. So, and plus my little town where my parents owned the bar where they were killed had 600 people in it. When, you know, the four major networks send their trucks to Boulder, Montana, you know, that pretty much took up all the parking places right there. You know, that's when the Inquirer and those types of papers were just getting a foothold in their sort of paparazzi chasing stuff. So when I went back there, there was a bit of a dust up. But the beauty was the town was 600 of my closest friends and of my parents' closest friends. So the whole town just rallied. They couldn't get an interview, they couldn't get anything. You know, they were offered so much money, more money than that town made in a year. And they all went, no. We don't do that around here.
Wow.
That was great. And when my sister and I would go for a drive to visit a neighbor and the cars would follow us, that we would phone somebody and say, we're going to go see so-and-so's. And then we would drive down and somebody would pull a hay wagon out across the street and the other cars would stop. And then we would just drive to our friends and nobody knew where we went. So it was a different kind of thing. But it was, in my mind, the beginning of that possibility of how intrusive something could be.
Patrick and Linda are as busy as ever, but dream of one day teaming up again.
Well, I would love to see you two do something more together, whether it be on the
right
stage
now?
Or...
Yeah.
Okay,
but you're going to have to explain this to my wife.
But is there a chance? I mean, have you been offered stage productions together? Have you been offered this? Or, I mean, you mentioned before that they feel that they just see...
Well, I think Dallas now, character. Though, to do a drama or something like on film, they're so used to our faces being our characters.
Yeah.
But, you know, to do a stage thing,
yeah.
I think that is putting bums in the seats, as they say. So that would happen. And we've been offered, you know, things like love letters and things like that to
Wouldn't
do together.
Be great?
You would be great.
In Australia, don't you think?
In Australia. Yeah, come and do
stage. I mean, we're just saying.
I don't know. My number is 555. Oh, never mind.
Why do all American numbers start with 555?
Well, because it's the only number that you can do that isn't traceable, so people won't dial that number and actually get somebody.
Oh, it's not actually a real number.
It's a fake number.
I never knew that.
Yeah. And that only started about 15, 20 years ago. They used to do numbers like Beechwood 45789. If you dial Beechwood 45789, somebody's phone rings. But if you dial 555, it is a non-contactable number, and that's why they're always... They'll do an area code, but then it's always 555.
You have solved one of the greatest mysteries of my life as to why all American TV shows and movies say 555. You're not just a pretty face, Patrick. I tell you, you are the real deal.
I'm pretty on all sides.
You are pretty on all sides. I think my 6 minutes is up. Thank you so much.
And our 15 minutes of fame is up too, so thanks for being here at the end.
Go. And we have to thank as well The Hollywood Show for giving us access to Patrick and Linda. Of course, another great job done by
them. He's aged quite nicely, hasn't he?
Yeah, they don't mind him at all with grey hair.
Mm.
It's like Dallas could be coming back again.
Maybe.